Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to get live stock quotes in a spreadsheet on your Mac. MacMost is supported by more than 500 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So I love using numbers, and it was great when a few years ago Apple introduced new functions to bring stock prices into cells in number spreadsheets. While that functionality originally gave us live stock prices, that soon changed to just daily closing prices. There's probably some sort of legal and licensing reason behind that. Live stock prices are really expensive. However, there is a way for you to get live stock prices in a spreadsheet on your Mac. It's not using numbers, but using Google spreadsheets instead. If you want, you can copy and paste between Google Sheets and numbers to combine the best of both. So Google Sheets is a spreadsheet app just like Excel and Numbers, except it's on the web and you access it through your Google account. So if you have a Gmail account or a YouTube account, you've got a Google account. You can go to drive.google.com and you have your file stored here. You get a certain amount of free space. Then you can click New, and one of the types of documents you can create is a Google Sheet. And when you do that, you get a simple spreadsheet here. This looks a lot more like Excel than it does numbers, but the same basic idea for entering formulas applies. So you can have numbers and all sorts of different things in here. So if I wanted to get a stock price, I'll start entering in a formula with the equals symbol, and the function I want is called Google Finance. So Google Finance, and then in quotes, the stock ticker symbol. And I'll get Apple stock price like that. Now a cleaner way to do it would be to have the ticker symbol here, and then in here change the formula so that it just refers to that cell. That way I can put something in another cell like that and then copy this formula here, Command C, Command V to paste, and now it'll grab the price of this symbol here. So you can create a whole list of stocks that you want to track. And then you can copy the function there and paste it in, and it will get all of those. You've got more options as well. So if I use Google Finance here, I can grab the symbol and I can say it's at a price. I can say volume. And then I can copy and paste that throughout here. If you want to see details on what you can do with the Google Finance function, go to Help, Function List, and then from here you can look for Google Finance, click Learn More. And then it gives you all the details, including all of the different attributes you can use. So price is the default. You saw I used volume, but you can do all sorts of different things. Market cap, the price at open, the low, the high, all sorts of different things. Note, you're still going to get a delay here. It's going to be about 20 minutes delayed, I assume, but it's a lot better than just the closing price for each day. You could flesh this out and make a really useful spreadsheet here. You could add the number of shares that you own multiplied by the stock price to see current value, different things like that, add styling and all. And then you could bookmark this page and just simply go back to it. But if you do want to go and use this data in numbers, you can. If you select this data here and use Command C to copy, and then switch to numbers, you can paste it in. When I paste it in there, it includes the styles. I'm going to undo that and I'm going to use Edit and then Paste and Match Style, or Option Shift Command V. And you can see that it follows along with the current style that's there. That way, if I've done things like, for instance, I've set these cells here to be currency, and these here to have 1,000 separators in them, for instance. When I copy new data from here, and then I switch to numbers, and then I go to paste it in using Shift Option Command V, it will keep the current formats for everything. So I can have a complex table here in numbers that has all sorts of things like the number of shares owned for each one, and then a calculation here for the number of shares owned times the current price. I can copy and paste that in here, add some headings. Then I could also add other columns like purchase price, and use that to calculate the change in value. So simply the number of shares owned times the current price minus the number of shares owned times the original purchase price. And you can see the change there, and you can copy and paste that throughout. And now if you wanted to update this information, you could just go back to your Google Sheet, select all of the data that you need, Command C to copy, go to Numbers, select the equivalent cells there, paste and match style. It updates the prices and volumes, and then your formulas and numbers update the value and change as well. So for some it may be worthwhile to keep all of this in numbers. Maybe you've got some complex things in here. Maybe you've got some charts and things you maintain. And then to copy the data from the Google Sheet to update things. Or some may just want to create a complex spreadsheet right here in Google Sheets and just go to that and not use numbers at all. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.